Welcome to Heidelberg. My name is Kerstin Haase. I'm delighted that you joined our sustainability talk. The climate change is one, or no, it is the most important topic these days. The European Union has significantly stepped up its climate targets at a special summit in December 2020. The aim is for greenhouse gas emissions to be 55% below 1990 levels by 2030. Consumers expect from brand owners sustainability targets, including and especially when it comes to packaging. The question that raises now is, how can packaging contribute? What are the trends? And what influence do printing methods, materials, and printing processes have? I'd now like to welcome my colleague, Harald Woerner. He's the expert for sustainability at Heidelberger Druckmaschinen. He's working on that topic for many, many years now. Hello, Harald.
Hi, Kerstin. Thank you.
So, Harald, what is the topic of today's talk? What have you brought us?
When I walk past the shelves in stores, I'm naturally always looking out for special packaging. One major trend you can find there is replacing plastics and aluminum and other things by cardboard. Have a look, for example, at this bottle holder. This bottle holder is made of cardboard. It replaces shrink wrap and thus replaces plastics. But additionally, it is a very nice printed brand ambassador.
So it is an exciting development and opportunity for the packaging printing industry.
Exactly, Kerstin. But it goes beyond material. There are inks and substrates which are certified for contact with food. Take, for example, this deep frozen food packaging. It's made with craft paper. On the outside, it's printed with water-based inks and thus protects the product and is very sustainable, easy to dispose of, very environmentally friendly.
So it meets all key sustainability criteria.
Correct.
And Harald, what is the idea behind all these developments?
Top priority is given to the fusion of function, form, sustainability and cost efficiency. But important as well is the production process, certainly. The brand owners and the print shops, they should put together their heads from an early stage onward and to develop very sustainable solutions that meet customer requirements. If they work together, then they can get the best results for customers and for the environment.
So all the equipment and the production processes contribute to sustainable packaging.
Exactly. Economy and ecology can go hand in hand, especially in production. Using energy efficient processes and reducing waste saves resources. Offsetting equipment emissions reduces the carbon footprint. What's more, a wide range of funding is available worldwide that can be accessible for sustainable investments.
So thank you, Harald. Thank you for today's insight. That brings us to the topic of our next sustainability talk, energy efficient equipment. Thank you for joining us today. We would like to invite you to our next talk and hope to see you there again. Bye-bye and all the best.